Last week on Attack U.
At Ohio University, my role is just to be an energy guy on and off the court, you know, coming in every day, you know, excited.
For the 14th time in Ohio University basketball history, Ohio wins 20 games in a season.
I get excited and like to, you know, give a couple of good claps.
I thought we handled each and every challenge with the thought in mind that then the game here against Akron would be for first place, and that's just the way we want it.
After Ohio's bracket buster game versus Belmont, the Cats turn their attention back to MAC play. Up next on the schedule, the league-leading and nationally ranked Akron Zips. Any game against an arch rival is big, but with the regular season title on the line, the Ohio ticket office was pushed into overdrive.
Yeah, on a typical Wednesday night, we're looking at, you know, with students in town, maybe 5,000, 6,000. You know, it's tough for people to drive from Columbus or drive from Cincinnati usually on a Wednesday night, but we've gotten many calls from people in Columbus, in Cincinnati, who are going to leave at 4 o'clock, leave work early just to come to this game. In my 3.5 years, this is the biggest home game, easily.
Over 11,000 flooded into Athens to see this battle between two MAC heavyweights, as many fans as all other MAC games that night combined.
This is a matchup of two very good teams. This 13,000 seat basketball venue will be packed up. 11 or 12,000 could be one of the biggest midweek crowds for a MAC game ever. And tonight, Ohio and Akron meet again. Very fitting, Rob C., that these two teams meet for the top of the league one more time.
Yeah, the best game of the year in this league happened in their gym a few weeks back.
It's the game of the year in the Mid-American Conference. It's 22 win and perfect in the league, Akron, and 20 win and one loss in the league, Ohio. And from a crammed convocation center in the Hocking Hills, it's time to get it on between these two rivals. The best teams in the Mid-American Conference set to go. Ohio and Akron, it's game on at the Convocation Center. Akron wins the tip and addresses the goal to our right. Walls at the top to Abreu, left wing, fires up a three and he got it. One pass, nets a three, 3-0 Akron. Treadwell, baseline right against Hall, bumps against him, fires it up with the left hand and he got it. 5-0 for the Zips early. Here comes Abreu, middle of the floor. Lead to Harney underneath the rim. Banker, yes, rolled around and down, and Jim Christian has to stop it. 7-0 Akron, 18:41 to go for the first half. How is the Bobcat crew going to deal with a haymaker early on from Akron? Into the post, a banking shot up and down. And Akron is on top, 9-0 on a Treadwell bucket. Goes to the right corner, Hall, drives past Treadwell. Look away, pass into the post. Keeley's right hand loop is good. Ohio down 7-9-2, 17:20 to go first half. Abreu, their point guard, stripped at the top. Cooper stole it away, flies it down the floor to Hall, who lays it in with the right hand. And now the convo gets a little loud. It's 9-4 Akron. Whips it corner right, Kellogg didn't fire. Drives on the baseline against two, loops it up and in. Stops, lets a man go by. Jump pass out high. It's Cooper. Gonna fire from 25. Bang! For DJ Cooper, and Ohio ties the ball game at 9. Oh, this building's jumping now. Didn't take much to pop him. Marshall's way out against him. 17 to shoot. Media timeout coming up. Marshall got blown by Cooper. High banker, yes! Cooper beat the 7-footer on a stroll to the goal. 13-11 Cats. Hall, ball fake, got Treadwell up. Extra pass to Smith, two-hand, rim rock. 19-13, Cats up 6. And they get it into Treadwell, works on Hall. He's not going to miss all night. Shot blocked away by Smith. Down to the floor, Johnson to Cooper, high on the right side. Baltic jump pass to the top. Wilkins tees up a three. Bang! 32-16. That's what Travis Wilkins does. Ohio has doubled up the Zips with 4:41 to go first half. Ohio on top and rolling, and the convo is live. Cooper picked the pocket of Abreu. Look away, pass into the post. Keeley with a one-hand rim rock. And the convo is jumping now. 34-16. Oh, baby, what a big-time run for the Bobcats.
Bad mojo on the Akron bench. You want to say, will they fold? Ohio has turned the 9-0 deficit into a 32-16 lead. That's 32-7 in the last 12 minutes.
Ohio on top of the Akron Zips at halftime at the Convocation Center. Marshall straight on. They give him a lot of cushion. Treadwell right of the paint, dribbles low block right. Banking shot, yes. When Ohio's lead is 9, it's 41-32. Repost to Marshall, bodying up on Keeley. Turns, right-hand hook is good. 45-36. Akron was down by 11 at the break. They have shaved 6 points off of that lead. Now it's Abreu to the left side. Kretzer jumps up a three. Got it. The lead's two. Akron's fans jump up here. Bounce into the post to Abreu to Harney, and he laid it in. Akron's lead is three. It's 48-45, 14-42 to go for the contest. Now to Wilkins, right wing. Decks it to the foul line. Lean in shot. Got it. Got it, and a foul. Hello, Travis Wilkins. This match, high on the right for three. Bang! We are tied! Oh, DJ Cooper is Superman. 72-68, Ohio's deficit is four. 105 to go for the game. Back Keeley, ball fake, drives on Marshall. Lean in shot, banking, yes! Counted and a foul. 47 seconds left. Ohio down two, 72-70. Reds to the line. Flies it up there, rimmed it out. Rebound Harney for Akron. Ohio is down two, 72-70. Driving baseline right, back up high on the left, it's Walsh. Now it's Harney, shoots from the foul line, rimmed it out. Rebound deflected out of bounds off of Akron. John Smith was right there too. So 12 seconds left for the game. Ohio will have the ball. Down two, 72-70. Sneaky dribbles across the timeline with nine. Now with eight, high on the left side with six. Now with five, dribble, handoff, waltz off and shoots for three. Off the iron, no, tip up, yes! With 0.7 seconds left, we're tied at 72. We're going to overtime. Drives on Keeley. Now Abreu drives, had the ball stripped, picked it back up, had the ball deflected again, ends up with Walsh, pocket right, Abreu for three, no, rebound follow, yes, by Walsh. 76-72, Ohio down four, high on the right, Walsh for three, off the iron, no, Treadwell got the rebound, banked it up and in, counted and a foul. 29 seconds left and Ohio's down seven, Ohio is not going to foul. And Akron will dribble this out, so Ohio loses in overtime to Akron, 88-81.
Well, it's a tough game. You know, we had set a lot of sights on that and the rematch of that game. And I thought for the first 20 minutes, we did a phenomenal job of everything we wanted to do. And then as the game wore on, I give Akron credit for not quitting and kept competing and raised their level of play and played very well. And we did a lot of great things. We took away a lot of great things from the game. We showed a lot of courage getting the game into overtime when we were down. And then probably didn't play as well as we would have liked in the overtime or as smart as we would have liked. And unfortunately, we weren't able to win the game. But again, you know, you play a great team at home. We had a legitimate chance to win a game. We had a shot to win it. A lot of little things could have been the difference in that game and just things we have to take away and get better.
Throughout the season, the Bobcats have relied heavily on their deep and talented bench to provide a spark when the starters need a break. Integral to that group of players and that spark is Ricardo Johnson. The junior from Covington, Kentucky is the definition of hustle.
Hustle means to me just being scrappy, who wants it more, just intimidating the opponent, who gonna set the tone, you know, in boxing, who's attacking more. So I feel like I take that on a little bit and hustle comes into play like that.
You know, Ricardo, you know, he's one of those guys that you know that when he gets in, he's going to play hard.
He brings it every game, every day in practice. You know what you're going to get out of him.
Well, you know, he's such a disciplined kid. I mean, he's such a hard worker on the court. He's such a hard worker in the classroom. He's kind of a, you know, a role model for how to go about being a college athlete, because I think he really understands it better than most, you know, the prioritizing of his time, the pride in which he does everything he does. And I think, you know, that's the byproduct of what he brings to the team.
My work ethic comes from, you know, just where I come from, you know, understanding if you want to be successful, you got to work hard, and knowing that there's always something bigger out there. Okay, I reached this accomplishment, but there's something else that I can accomplish. So you have to keep working to get to where you want to go.
He's a happy kid. I mean, he's one of those guys very rarely not in a good mood, you know, very rarely down. He just brings a lot of energy, and he's not the biggest talker, but he enjoys what he does, and I think he's really happy being at Ohio University. I think he's happy being on his basketball team, and he's a fun guy to be around.
It's part of my personality. I just think maybe I smile a lot because the problems out here in the world, it's bigger than my problems, and maybe help me if I smile a lot. You know, just nobody can never know. Just be happy, because there's always a bigger problem than your problems out there. The hair is just, you know, actually I had a conversation with John Smith on the team. At first it was a nappy fro, as TJ would be a prime example of a nappy fro. So then I thought about something else. I went with the high top, which I don't know. It's just old 90s, Gumby, or the old Nino Brown, or I don't know, just something different. When I went back home over Christmas, I went to my old high school, and there was three players on the basketball team that had it. So I kind of think that I influenced that a little bit.
Just for the people back home watching, this crab dribble, you gotta look, man. And you just punish, you just drop him off in the bucket like that. I can keep going.
No, now it's my turn.
Watch this great defense.
Watch this great post offense.
Oh! Give him a little ball.
And then you just get with that one. Yeah, put that on film.
While most Bobcats are busy leading a typical college lifestyle, Travis Wilkins' time off the court is a little different. In August 2011, the junior guard married the girl of his dreams. A year later, they moved to Athens, where Wilkins has been a key contributor for the Cats.
You know, Travis is a very mature kid. I mean, he's an older guy. I think he has a really, he really understands his role and what the team needs from him. I mean, it's not many guys on our team who are in the gym more than Travis, shooting, working on certain things. You know, he has to make sure that, you know, she's comfortable, taken care of, and she has, you know, familiar and comfortable in the Athens community, which they both are. And I think that helps, you know, anytime I'm married. So when your wife is happy, you're usually happy. If your wife's unhappy, then you're usually unhappy. And I think that it's just been a great fit for them, and they both have been a great fit for our basketball family.
We went to high school together in Willard, Missouri. He was a couple years older than me, so we weren't actually even friends, but we kind of knew of each other. I knew him because he played basketball, and I went to all the games. He claims that he knew me, but I don't know. And then he actually graduated, went and lived in 2 years in Argentina. And then when he came back, in the meantime, I became good friends with his little sister, who's like a year younger than me. And so I was always over at their house. And then he came home for the summer after a year playing at Snow. And then we just kind of started hanging out and then dating.
She says that she was really good friends with my little sister. I think she became really good friends with my little sister just to get to me. So she's kind of making that part of the story up. After dating her for a year or so, I just knew she was the girl that I was supposed to marry, and everything's been good ever since.
Whenever he's gone, I mean, it's kind of a bittersweet. No, I'm just kidding. I'm totally kidding. It does suck. I mean, in a way, I've kind of gotten used to it, but I mean, I always, by the time he comes home, I'm usually missing him really bad, but I do work full-time, I do go to school. It is kind of hard, but like I said, I kind of get used to it, and by the end of the season, I mean, I love basketball season, but it's kind of good that I kind of look forward to it kind of ending so that I don't have to go through that every week. So it is, I do miss him, so.
They recruited me here because I'm a shooter, so I have to be able to knock down open shots. Also, I know he wants me to do the small, simple things like dive on the floor, take charges.
I just think he's really good. Like, I'm his wife, so I'm gonna be kind of biased about it, but I feel like he's a good player all around, I think. Definitely shooter, for sure.
Shoot. What else?
I don't know.
After the overtime loss to Akron, the Bobcats must quickly regroup and begin to look ahead. Up next on the schedule is a trip to Bowling Green. A win and the Cats lock up the number 2 seed in the conference tournament. giving them a bye all the way to the semifinals.
BG is going to be a tough place, you know, because since I've been here in Athens, you know, we haven't won up there.
They always seem to give us a hard time at their place, but, you know, we got them here at home first, and I think, you know, it starts with defending and rebounding. As long as we defend and rebound, I think it'd be fine.
BG is a good team, you know, they're athletic, and, you know, we just got to come out and win. You know, I never won, or, you know, the four seniors, we never won at BG since we've been here.
This is the time of the year we want our basketball team to start playing well, and for individually and collectively. You know, there's some guys on our team who are struggling and been struggling for a little bit, and we're trying to get those guys going. And our team's just got to start, you know, trying to get clicking on all cylinders as we get ready for the conference tournament.
All right, here we go. Just going to get a couple juggles in at first. Then we'll balance it. And we'll hit it with the one leg. We'll hit it with the one leg. Oh, don't fall off. Ah, dang it. I missed the two leg, but I got the one leg. That's all I got. I'm out. That's all I got for right now. Oh, he's hitting him with the rainbow.
That's buffoonery.
That is buffoonery.
Oh, we got
fair. That's buffoonery.
While there may be some buffoonery on the practice court, the Bobcats are all business as they make their way to the windswept plains of Northwest Ohio to battle the Bowling Green Falcons.
In Northwest Ohio today to take on an old rival, a team that has beaten them in the all-time season series, the only MAC school to have the upper hand on the green and white.
It's a hard one for Ohio. You're maybe a little hard to get motivated coming off that Akron game, a rough game midweek. And for Bowling Green, I mean, this season has been up and down, but they have yet to really put a really big string together of wins or losses. Still pretty good in this building.
It's 20-8, 11-2 Ohio University, and 12-16, and 6-7 Bowling Green State University. And from Northwest Ohio, it's time for Bobcat basketball. 13 to shoot, one power dribble into the paint. Stranded gets it to Orr, cuts it right of the paint, low block right, banker up and in for Chauncey Orr. And Ohio is down 2-0. Black in the lane at the back logo. Back to the left side, Crawford for three, got it. Right in front of Ohio's bench, 5-0, Bowling Green on top. Back to Kellogg, baseline right, Baltic spins on Calhoun, reverse layup, yes. And Ohio's first bucket brings him down 3-5-2. Into the post now, it is off, it loops it up and in with a little contact, a little post touch off of that media stoppage, and Ohio is down 1-7-6. Cooper on the right sideline for the Cats. Chucks it into the post, Keeley right back up with it. Banker, yes. On Rashawn Holmes, who checked into the ballgame for Bowling Green, and Ohio leads for the first time, 8-7. Orr, corner right, checked by Johnson. Johnson all over him, and now Orr has to pedal it back high on the right side. Pick from Calhoun, they can't throw it to the screener. Great defense here, Johnson all over him. Shot clock was waning, they chucked it up, they didn't know it, shot clock violation. Rebound down to the ground, picked up by Johnson, goes up and scores with a right hand. And Ohio on a run, 12-7 Cats. And now Ohio has the ball, left wing. Cooper pitching to the post, Johnson goes up against contact, threw it up and in, counted and a foul. And they look, and they look, and the count's on, and they throw it to Seeley. Ball deflected by Kellogg, ends up with Johnson. Into the post, off at Banker, yes! Ohio is running things in Northwest Ohio on the defensive end, 24-15. Johnson to corner left, Kellogg for three. Bang for Nick Kellogg. Ohio's lead is 10. Runs along the right sideline into the front court. Skips it corner left, Kellogg for three. Book it for Nick. And maybe this is the game where he really starts to heat up. 8 for Nick Kellogg today. 4 point left, Kellogg stripped the ball away. He'll run to the goal and he'll lay it in. If he has a big run at the end of the season now, the day that starts it all is today. right point three, rim no. Followed, blocked by John Smith. Orr went up there, not strong enough with two hands. Tried to bank it in, and Smith rejected it. Corner left, Wilkins for three. Bang! For Travis Wilkins, Ohio enjoying a pretty handsome lead. 39-28, 104 to go for the first half. Offered in between the circles with five and four. Back to the right side, Calhoun for three. Got it. 39-33, Ohio can't get the ball in. Ohio had a chance to edge out a little bit more towards halftime, and then boom, go figure, Bowling Green right back into it. And Green has the ball to start the second half, and they get it into the post to Calhoun, who banks it up there. Back to the left hash, left wing, it's Crawford. Now to Black, into the post, Calhoun banked it up and in on John Smith, and Bowling Green takes the lead, it's 40-39.
BG recently on a 12-0 run, going back to the first half.
That 2-3 zone again. Kellogg at the point, now to Cooper, point left for three. Book it. Ohio back on top, 42-40. Ball thrown left wing and it's stripped away. Off and got in there, Wilkins runs to the foul line. Now it's Walter Keeley, right hand push, yes. Reggie at 17, and just like that, Ohio's lead is 7 again. Right back to Trav, drives baseline right to the goal. Left hand layup on the right hand side. Off of the inbound, it's a catch, corner left, Kellogg for three, bang! Keeley faces up on Calhoun, takes him, spins on him, low block left, shoots and scores! 17 points for Keeley.
Another 2 minutes, how do we put games away? We're gonna be in this situation a lot for bigger marbles than this. Let's learn, let's go.
Dribbles away from him, throws back to Smith, corner left, Kellogg for three, bang! 13 point lead, 2:11 to go, could be the dagger at BG. And with this win, Ohio clinches the 2 seed and the bye all the way to the semifinals at the Mid-American Conference Tournament coming up in mid-March in Cleveland.
Guys, at halftime, I challenged you guys to step up in the last 10 minutes is as well as we've played in a while. Most importantly, Bobcats got better today. Individually and collectively, we got better. Great job, guys.
Good job, fellas. Good job.
Together on three. One, two, three. Yeah.